Welcome back. If you enjoyed the blockbuster hits Mystic River, Gone Baby Gone, and Shutter Island, you're going to want to snag a copy of the latest book from Dennis Lehane. It's called World Gone By right here. And that best-selling author, who happens to be from Dorchester, Mass., I think you have to say it like that, is joining us now via satellite to talk about this new book. Good morning, Dennis.
Hi, how are you?
Good to have you with us this morning. First of all, congratulations on all of your success. We hear you've got a movie coming out this fall, and that's going to mark your screenwriting debut.
Actually, it's already come out. It's called The Drop. It came out last fall.
And also, Ben Affleck is going to be producing and directing another movie with you, right?
Yeah, Live by Night. It's supposedly going to go into production in June.
And Leonardo DiCaprio is going to be part of that as well?
He's a producer.
Good stuff. All right, first, let's get to the book itself. World Gone By is the book. Tell us a little bit about this story, because this is the third time that you have brought character Joe Coughlin back in a book.
Yeah, and he's a little older now. This is sort of the title really says it all. This is kind of about the moment in your life where you start to see the world you knew beginning to slip away. It's about change. It's about a sense of maybe fatalism and destiny. Joe has been dancing on a hot plate for most of his life, and he might ultimately be running out of steam.
For some authors, they'll write about a character, they'll let it go, they'll put it away, put it to bed. What is it about this character that made you want to not bring him back once, twice, but back three times?
There was just something about him as a sort of a guide through the history of the first half of the 20th century. And so we meet him first as a little boy in The Given Day, and then in his 20s as a sort of gangster on the rise in Live by Night. And now this is the sort of winter of his discontent. This is Joe Coughlin as a man heading into middle age, questioning the decisions he's made.
And also in the book, I was reading that he also finds out, obviously, he's lost his wife, and then also finds out that there's a contract out on his life.
There may be. It doesn't make sense because he's considered the golden goose. He's a consigliere. He's the connection between the mafia and legitimate business in Tampa in 1943. So it makes no sense. And yet, no matter how little sense it makes, if somebody told you somebody was trying to kill you, you'd take it seriously.
For you as an author, what is it like to actually sit down, look at a blank screen, and put together a book like something like this, something that you hope that readers are going to enjoy? Do you always have the reader in the back of your mind? Because it's got to be tough to put something on paper and actually make sure that they keep turning the pages.
Well, yeah, I mean, the rule is, are you telling the best story you know how to tell? So with that in mind, yes, I'm always thinking of the reader. The process itself depends upon a book. I mean, each book is different. Sometimes books are so easy to write, they practically write themselves. And sometimes they're murderous. And it's just it's a process built for sadomasochists.
And do you hope this becomes a film someday, too? Because just by looking at it, just by going through it, it has every potential of becoming a movie.
I'd be fine with it becoming a movie, but it sounds strange, but it would make little difference to me if it doesn't. The book is the book. A movie is a different thing.
All right, well, good stuff. Thanks so much for being on with us today. And you can pick up a copy of World Gone By, available online and in stores, and that's going to start today.